Well, good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with a quick look at the North American stock markets for Tuesday morning. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures and commodities are flat, so we're not getting any real direction from futures traders in the pre-market on Tuesday morning. Now, last week we were watching to see how the market would react to the Fed meeting, and the initial reaction was bullish. We got some fall through to the upside the next day, which was enough to fill the open gap on the S&P 500 chart, and then the market has started to reverse. So the world would be a lot different today, and we'd have much more of a bullish tone to the market if we were breaking out above 2187.50. That is not the case, and now we're looking to hold recent support down at the 2125 area. Of course, 2125 is a famous number because that's where the market petered out in 2015, and so we're looking to see if that level holds. You can see last week we ran up, filled that open gap, so the initial reaction was just short covering. We got some fall through to the upside, but that petered out fairly quickly, could not get new buyers into this market. And of course, a lot of it has to do with the weakness in the financial services sector. And so looking at the chart, you can see that yesterday's low came right down to the lower channel line, so a close below 2144.51 would give us a sell signal on Tuesday. Looking at what happened last week, we did put in a lower high on the S&P 500, so that's bearish. We did put in a higher low on the VIX, and that is bullish for the VIX, which is negative for the stock market. So looking to see if the VIX will give us another buy signal here. The TSX, so looking north of the border, the TSX tried to break out above the previous highs, could not do it. So that looks like a triple top. And now we're looking to see if we generate a sell signal. We need to close below 14,556 on Tuesday to give us a sell signal there. Now we've seen a lot more strength in the NASDAQ recently. It made a new high last week, but that has failed. We've come back, filled the open gap, and now we're back in the channel. So it closed below 4793.71 would give us a sell signal on Tuesday. Now, much of the strength from last week in the NASDAQ was the chip sector. It was also Apple Computer. Apple Computer had an inside day yesterday. We're looking for a close below 111.21 on Tuesday to give us a sell signal there. Now, one of the things that kept me in check last week was the weakness in the U.S. banking sector. Could not generate new buy signals last week. And so yesterday we put in a lower low for this sector. So the banking sector in the U.S. is leading the market lower right now. Bank of America could not generate a buy signal last week. Did trade up to the upper channel line, but could not close above it. Wells Fargo, of course, has been in the news a lot recently. It made a new low yesterday. Now looking over in Europe, Deutsche Bank gapped lower once again yesterday, making a new low for this move. This morning in the pre-market, it's down once again. Hasn't traded down below yesterday's low just yet, but it's heading in that direction. North of the border, TSX Financial Services Index had a lot better week last week than in the U.S. We're trading back in the channel on Monday. The Royal Bank traded through the lower channel line on Monday. On Tuesday, we need to close below 80.78 to give us a sell signal. Looking at gold and silver stocks, the XAU, the TSX Gold Index, pulled back yesterday. You can see we're trading in the middle of a range, and we traded up to the September high last week. We still have the bottom of that open gap that could potentially act as resistance. On the way down, we've got the September and then the late August low as potential areas of support. Looking at the TSX Gold Index, we were able to trade into that open gap last week and take out the September highs. So we made a higher high there, so that's a little bullish, but we're still looking to see if we can hold the lower channel line this week. Looking at gold itself, it was up yesterday, inside day for crude oil, inside day for natural gas. All three of the major commodities are still on buy signals. Last up, let's take a look at a couple 60-minute charts and what's going to change things on Tuesday. You need to see an hourly close above 2158.13 on the S&P 500 cash index to give us an intraday buy signal. 4841.99 on the NASDAQ 100, 14,679 on the TSX, and 96.29, an hourly close above that level for the XAU, would give us a new intraday buy signal for the gold and silver sector. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Fairly quiet after last night's debate, and we're looking to see if we can hold the 21.25 level on the S&P 500 cash index. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again next on Wednesday morning.